The wife of former palace spokesperson Harry Roque denies refusing to appear before the House Quad Committee. Myla Roque was cited in contempt by the panel last Friday and ordered arrested over her repeated failure to attend its hearings. In a statement, Roque says she has been regularly complying with the QuadCom's documentary requirements. She adds every time she submits medical documents, the lawmakers always ask for additional information, which already violates her right to privacy. Roque believes there is nothing she can submit that will satisfy the panel. Roque is being asked to shed light on her role in signing a lease agreement with Chinese nationals linked to the Pogo complex in Bamban, Tarlac. Her husband has also been ordered detained by the House panel, but has since gone into hiding. The Southeast Asian leaders calling for a swift agreement on a code of conduct for the South China Sea. A statement by the Association of Southeast Asian Nations calls for confidence-building measures that could reduce tensions and the risk of misunderstandings in the disputed waters. It's also looking to establish an early accord for an effective and substantive code of conduct in accordance with international law. Last week's ASEAN summit ended without a joint communique explicitly calling out China's illegal actions in the South China Sea. This despite strong statements against Chinese aggression from Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and other world leaders. Pag-asa not currently monitoring any low-pressure area, but possible flash floods and landslides are still on the forecast. Let's get an update on the weather now from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. No tropical cyclone is expected in the country this week. However, scattered rains will still be experienced in some areas. This Monday, a shear line where cold and hot air masses meet affects the extreme northern Luzon, while the moist easterlies from the Pacific blows over the rest of the country. Together, the weather systems bring rains over Cagayan Valley, Aurora, and Quezon. The rest of northern and central Luzon, Mimaropa, Bicol region, western and eastern Visayas, and most of Mindanao will also expect thunderstorms later today. The easterlies has also caused the scattered rains here in Metro Manila since this morning, and more rains may be expected later. The Philippines remains in the transition period towards the northeast monsoon season or Amihan season, while ENSO-neutral conditions prevail over the equatorial Pacific, meaning it's not yet La Niña. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Ariel Rojas, there joining us live. Well, a big-time oil price hike set Tuesday. Gasoline will see the biggest jump of 2 pesos and 65 centavos per liter, while kerosene and diesel prices will both increase by 2 pesos and 60 centavos per liter. This marks the fourth straight week of fuel price hikes amid concerns on supply disruption due to the increasing tensions in the Middle East. Vehicle owners living near the southern portion of Metro Manila will now have another option for registering with the Land Transportation Office. The Parañaque Terminal Exchange, or PITEX, has announced a partnership with the government agency to offer a more convenient location for the registration renewals. The service is available for cars and motorcycles. It already has an existing partnership with the LTO for driver's license applications and renewals. North Korea says it stands ready to fire amid tensions over drones supposedly sent by South Korea. State media said artillery units stationed at the border have been ordered on standby. On Friday, North Korea accused the South of sending drones into Pyongyang, saying the intrusion demanded retaliatory action. In recent years, some defectors and activists in South Korea had been flying aid parcels into the North containing K-pop and K-drama files and leaflets criticizing Kim Jong-un.